Namaste, and once again welcome back to another session of online mathematics class. In this session we move on to the topic combinations. What is a combination? Combination means selection or grouping. The number of combinations of n different objects taken r at a time is denoted by ncr, and it is given by ncr equal to n factorial by r factorial into n minus r the whole factorial, where 0 less than or equal to r less than or is equal to n, right? So the number of combinations of n different objects taken r at a time is denoted by ncr, and it is given by ncr equal to n factorial by r factorial into n minus r the whole factorial, where 0 less than or equal to r less than or is equal to n. Okay, and in the last class we have discussed about permutations. Permutation is an arrangement, okay, in which order is important. Here order doesn't matter. In a combination, order is not important, right? And the permutation formula is npr is equal to n factorial by n minus r the whole factorial. Okay, now we can derive a relation between permutation and combination formulas. If we multiply ncr into r factorial, this r factorial get cancelled and we get what? Npr. Okay, so we can write r factorial into ncr is equal to n factorial by, here r factorial get cancelled, we get n minus r the whole factorial, and which is equal to npr. Or we can write npr is equal to ncr into r factorial. So this relation you have to by heart. Npr equal to ncr into r factorial. And some more points you have to keep in mind is, when r equal to 0, the equation reduces to nc0 equal to n factorial by 0 factorial into n minus 0 the whole factorial, and which is equal to n factorial by n factorial, that is 1. That means nc0 is equal to 1. So it's one of the important points. nc0 is equal to 1. And what about if r equal to n? When r is equal to n, ncn is equal to n factorial by n factorial into n minus n the whole factorial. That is, here we can cancel n factorial and n factorial. 1 by 0 factorial. 0 factorial, the value is 1. So the answer is 1. That is ncn equal to 1. So what we can conclude? nc0 equal to 1. ncn is also is equal to 1. Okay. Next one is about ncn minus r. ncn minus r. If you apply the formula, we get n factorial by, in the place of r, it is n minus r. So, n minus r the whole factorial into, then n minus r, that is n minus of n minus r the whole factorial. That is n factorial by n minus r the whole factorial into, if we change the bracket, n get cancelled and we get r factorial. And what is this? N factorial by n minus r the whole factorial into r factorial. It is nothing but ncr. Okay. So which is equal to ncr. This is another relation. ncn minus r is equal to ncr. ncn minus r is equal to ncr. Okay. Next one important point is nca equal to ncb implies either a equal to b or a plus b is equal to n. Okay. NCA equal to NCB implies A equal to B or N is equal to A plus B. This is another relation. NCA is equal to NCB implies either A equal to B or A plus B is equal to N or N equal to A plus B. Right. Next one is NCR plus NCR minus 1, which is equal to N plus 1 CR. NCR plus NCR minus 1 is equal to N plus 1 CR. So a combination means selection or grouping, and in a combination order doesn't matter. Order is not important. And the number of combinations of N different objects taken R at a time is denoted by NCR, and it is given by NCR equal to N factorial by R factorial into N minus R the whole factorial, where 0 less than or equal to R less than or equal to N. And some important point you have to keep in mind is NPR equal to NCR into R factorial, then NC 0 equal to 1, NC N is equal to 1, then NC N minus R equal to NCR, NC A equal to NCB implies A equal to B or N is equal to A plus B, and the last one is NCR plus NCR minus 1 is equal to N plus 1 CR. So these are the important points you have to keep in mind in this session, combinations. Okay, now we shall discuss exercise 7.4. Okay. Now we move on to the first question in exercise 7.4 of NCERT class 11 mathematics text. The question is, if NC 8 is equal to NC 2, find NC 2. So here we can find N first. N is equal to A plus B. Here it is 8 and 2. So 8 plus 2, which gives 10. Now NC 2. NC 2 is equal to 10 C 2. According to the formula, 10 factorial by 2 factorial into 10 minus 2 the whole factorial. Okay, NCR equal to N factorial by R factorial into N minus R the whole factorial. And which is equal to 10 factorial by 2 factorial into 8 factorial. 10 factorial can be rewritten as 8 factorial into 9 into 10. Divided by this 2 factorial we can write 1 into 2. Then 8 factorial as it is. We can cancel this 8 factorial and 8 factorial and on 2 and 10, 5, 9 into 5, 9 5s are 45. So our answer is 45. NC2 or 10C2 is equal to 45. Clear? Here the second question is, determine N if there are two sub questions, 2NC3 is to NC3 equal to 12 is to 1, and the second one, 2NC3 is to NC3 is equal to 11 is to 1. Take the first one. A is to B equal to C is to D, which implies A by B equal to C by D. The similar problems we have discussed in the last exercise. Okay. In permutation, we have already discussed the same topic. So here we can write 2NC3 divided by NC3 equal to 12 by 1. A is to B equal to C is to D implies A by B is equal to C by D. Now we can apply the formula. NCR, N factorial, here 2N factorial by R factorial, that is 3 factorial into N minus R the whole factorial, 2N minus 3 the whole factorial by NC3, N factorial by 3 factorial into N minus 3 the whole factorial, which is equal to 12 by 1 is 12. Okay. 2N factorial means the product of first N natural numbers. 1 into 2 into 3 into etc. up to N is what? N factorial. Here 2N factorial, that means 1 into 2 into 3 into etc. up to 2N. Okay. So this can be written as 2n minus 3 factorial, then 2n minus 2, 2n minus 1 and 2n. Okay, if you write the previous terms, we get 2n minus 1, then 2n minus 2, then 2n minus 3. We can subtract 1 to get previous terms. Okay. Because they are the continuous natural numbers. Right. In order to cancel this with 2n minus 3, the whole factorial, we do this. Right. And here we can cancel 3 factorial and 3 factorial directly. Here the remaining is divided by 2n minus 3, the whole factorial. Then by n factorial, we can also write the previous terms. N, then n minus 1, n minus 2, then n minus 3. Here we can put factorial notation. Okay. N factorial can be written as n minus 3 factorial into n minus 2 into n minus 1 into n. Divided by n minus 3 whole factorial. Which is equal to 12. We can cancel 2n minus 3 factorial, 2n minus 3 factorial, then here on n minus 3 factorial, n minus 3 factorial. Okay, from the remaining term, this 2n minus 2, we can take on 2 common, 2 into n minus 1, then 2n minus 1 into 2 divided by, here n minus 2 into n minus 1, which is equal to 12. n minus 1 we can cancel and we can cross multiply this term. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2n minus 1 is equal to 12 into n minus 2. And we can cancel this 4 and 12, we will get 3. 3 fours are 12. So 2n minus 1 is equal to 3n minus 6. We can take 3n to the left side, that is 2n minus 3n is equal to minus 6 plus 1. Minus n is equal to minus 5. Minus and minus we can cancel. Therefore, n is equal to 5. So, here the value of n is 5. Similarly, you can do the second one. Here the only difference is, instead of 12 is to 1, here they are given 11 is to 1. So, this is a homework. Do it yourself. Okay. Here the third question is, how many chords can be drawn through 21 points on a circle? We know in order to draw a chord, we need minimum 2 points at a time. Okay, chord is a line segment connecting any 2 points on the circle. Right. So, here we have 21 points. That means total number of objects is 21. That is n is equal to 21 and r is equal to 2. Okay. And the number of chords is equal to NCR. Here 21C2. Now we can apply the formula. 21 factorial by 2 factorial into 21 minus 2 the whole factorial. That is 21 factorial by 2 factorial into 19 factorial. This 21 factorial can be rewritten as 19 factorial into 20 into 21 divided by 2 factorial, that is 1 into 2 into 19 factorial. This 19 factorial we can cancel. 2 and 20 we can cancel, 10. So the answer is 210. That means the number of chords can be drawn through 21 points on a circle will be equal to 210. Okay. Now we move on to question number 4. In how many ways can a team of 3 boys and 3 girls be selected from 5 boys and 4 girls? Okay. So here we have 5 boys and 4 girls. Among them we have to select a team which consists of 3 boys and 3 girls. So in how many ways we can select 3 boys from 5 boys? It can be done in 5C3 ways. Total number of boys is 5 and we have to select 3 from them. Okay. So, it can be done in 5C3 ways. So, 3 boys can be selected in 5C3 ways. Similarly, 3 girls can be selected in 4C3 ways because the total number of girls is 4. Okay. So in order to find the final answer, that means the number of ways in which we can select the team will be equal to the product of these two values, that is 5C3 into 4C3. Okay. So therefore we can write number of ways in which the team is selected is equal to 5C3 into 4C3. We can apply the formula. 5C3 is 5 factorial by 3 factorial into 5 minus 3, that is 2 factorial. Here 4C3, 4 factorial by 3 factorial into 4 minus 3 the whole factor, that is 1 factorial. Okay. Now we can write 5 factorial as 3 factorial into 4 into 5 divided by 3 factorial into 1 into 2. We can cancel. Here 4 factorial, 3 factorial into 4 divided by 3 factorial. Here we can cancel. This 2 and 4 we can cancel 2. 2 5s are 10. 10 into 4, 40. So in 40 ways we can select the team. Okay. Here the next question is, find the number of ways of selecting 9 balls from 6 red balls, 5 white balls and 5 blue balls. If each selection consists of exactly 3 balls of each color. Okay, that means we have to select 3 red balls, 3 white balls and 3 blue balls. Okay, total 9 balls. Okay, so here we can select 3 red balls from 6 red balls in 6C3 ways. Similarly, 3 white balls from 5 white balls in 5C3 ways. Okay, and 3 blue balls from 5 blue balls in 5C3 ways. So it's quite easy. You have to take the product in order to get the final answer. Okay, so the total number of ways is equal to 6C3 into 5C3 into 5C3. That is 6 factorial by 3 factorial into 6 minus 3. 3 factorial. Then 5 factorial by 3 factorial into 5 minus 3. 2 factorial. Here also 5 factorial by 3 factorial into 2 factorial. So this can be written as 3 factorial into 4 into 5 into 6 divided by 1 3 factorial, and 1 3 factorial we can write 1 into 2 into 3. This 3 factorial we can cancel. 3 2s are 6, we can cancel with 6. Here 5 factorial, that is 3 factorial into 4 into 5 divided by 3 factorial. Then 2 factorial, 1 into 2. 3 factorial we can cancel. 2 and 4 we can cancel, we get a 2. Then into, here also 3 factorial into 4 into 5 divided by 3 factorial, then 1 into 2. 3 factorial cancel, 4 and 2 cancel, we get a 2. So 4 into 5, 20. 2 into 5, 10. 2 into 5, 10. So the final answer is 2000. Okay, the total number of ways of selecting 9 balls from 6 red, 5 white and 5 blue balls will be equal to 2000. Clear? Now we move on to question number 6. Determine the number of 5 card combinations out of a deck of 52 cards. If there is exactly 1 ace in each combination, we have to select 5 cards from 52 cards in such a way that there is 1 as in each combination. Okay, and we know 52 cards contains 4 ace cards and the remaining 48 non-ace cards. Okay, so among the 4 ace cards, we have to choose one card. And among the 48 non-ace cards, we have to choose the remaining 4 cards. Total number 5. Okay, so from these 4 cards, we can choose one card in 47 ways. And from this 48 non-ace cards, we have to select 4 cards. It can be done in 48 C4 ways. Okay, so the product is our answer. The number of ways is equal to 4C1 into 48C4, which is equal to 4C1. 4C1 is 4 because NC1 is equal to N. Okay. Then 48C4, 48 factorial by 4 factorial into 48 minus 4, that is 44 factorial. And which is equal to 4 into 44 factorial into 45 into 46 into 47 into 48 divided by 4 factorial can be written as 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. Then into 44 factorial. This 44 factorial we can cancel. 4 and 4 get cancelled. This 3 and 45 we can cancel. 15. This 2 and 46 we can cancel. 23. And we can multiply 15, 23, 47 and 48 to get the final answer. And it is 7,78,320. Our final answer is 7,78,320. Okay. Here the next question is, in how many ways can one select a cricket team of 11 from 17 players? We have to select 11 from 17 players. Okay. But there is a condition in which only 5 players can bowl. Among the 17 players, only 5 players can bowl. Okay. So, in this list, 5 bowlers are there. Okay. So, there will be 12 remaining players. If each cricket team of 11 must include exactly 4 bowlers. So we have to select 11 players in such a way that each team must include exactly 4 bowlers. As we know, bowlers can only be selected from bowlers. Okay. And here we have 5 bowlers and we have to select 4 bowlers. Okay. And this can be done in 5C4 verse. Okay, the bowlers can be selected in 5C4 ways. Total number of players we need is 11 in order to make a team. So here we select 4 players. So the remaining is 7. Now we need 7 players. Okay, so these 7 players can be selected from the remaining 12 players. Understood? Total number of players is 17. The selection of bowlers is already over. So we can remove the players from the list. So 17 minus 5, the remaining is 12. And among the 12 players, okay, we can select 7. And it can be done in 12C7 ways. Clear? So the number of ways of selecting the cricket team will be equal to 5C4 into 12C7. And which is equal to 5 factorial by 4 factorial into 5 minus 4, 1. Then 12C7, 12 factorial by 7 factorial into 12 minus 7, 5. That is 4 factorial into 5. Here 4 factorial and cancel. Then 12 factorial, 7 factorial into 8 into 9 into 10 into 11 into 12 divided by 7 factorial into 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. The 7 factorial we can cancel. 4 and 2, 8 we can cancel. then 3, 3 3s are 9, 5, 2 5s are 10. So the remaining is 5 into 3 into 2, 3 into 2 6, 6 into 11, 66 into 12. And on multiplication we get 3960, 3960. So the total number of base is 3960. Okay. Next one is, a bag contains 5 black and 6 red balls. 5 black and 6 red balls. Determine the number of ways in which 2 black and 3 red balls can be selected. Okay. So here we have to select 2 black balls. And total number of black balls is 5. So this can be done in 5C2 ways. Okay. And we have to select 3 red balls. The total number of red balls available is 6. So that can be done in 6C3 ways. So the number of ways is equal to 5C2 into 6C3. The remaining part you can do it yourself. Okay. Now we move on to the last question in this exercise. In how many ways can a student choose a program of 5 courses? 9 courses are available and 2 specific courses are compulsory for every student. Here we have to choose a program of 5 courses from 9 courses. So 5 from 9. If there is no subcondition is given, it can be done in 9C5 ways. Okay. But there is a condition that 2 specific courses are compulsory. Here 2 courses are compulsory. That means we can remove that 2 courses from the selection list. Why? Because we have no other option. We have to choose it compulsory. Okay, we have to select that 2 particular courses. Okay, so we can subtract this from the list. So here we have 7 courses now. Okay, and we have to select 3 from the list, because 2 courses are compulsory. That 2 courses are already included in the 5 courses. So selection will be on the 3 subjects or 3 courses. Okay. So the remaining 7 courses, we have to choose 3 courses. Is that clear? Total number of courses is 9, in which 2 courses are compulsory. Okay. The compulsory courses is subtracted from the list. So we have 7 courses available for selection. And how many courses we have to select? Only 3 courses. Because among the 5, 2 is compulsory. So 3 courses. So our answer will be 7C3. So the number of ways is equal to 7C3. That is 7 factorial by 3 factorial into 4 factorial. 4 factorial into 5 into 6 into 7 by 3 factorial. 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 factorial. We can cancel 4 factorial. 3 into 2, 6. We can cancel with the 6. And 5 into 7, 35. So our answer is 35. In 35 different ways, a student can choose these 5 programs. Okay. So this finishes exercise 7.4 as well as the chapter permutations and combinations. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thanks for watching. Thank you.